Behind us we can see the configuration of the so-called HX truck, which is part of our proposal for the Romanian army. What we have here in front of us is the configuration for the German army. It's a so-called UTF program. The German army has just signed a contract with us for a couple of thousand trucks. We strongly believe that given the design of the Romanian army, the compatibility with other NATO forces is a key driver. This truck that you see here is introduced in many NATO armies, so it will provide the Romanian army a perfect platform, not only for Romania, but also for in-theater operations. The requirement is a mixture between, let's say, militarized commercial trucks and military trucks. It's a significant figure. We understand that this lot until 2027 is the first of a number of lots. The entire requirement is probably something like 10,000 vehicles. So it's a very significant program. The mixture is roughly 10% military trucks like this one and 90% militarized trucks. The truck we see here in the background is a purely military truck, so it was initially designed for the German army to follow the Leopard main battle tank off-road, so it really has a unique off-road capability, and also it has the capacity to integrate a protected cabin. I think one element that we cannot stress enough is that the crews of logistical vehicles in theater deserve to have a similar protection level as their comrades who are in fighting vehicles. And this truck here, due to the capacity of its axles, can integrate very high protected cabins. Well, we have two elements here really. One is the, let's say, the production phase, where we are looking at elements such as local assembly and integration of local suppliers. We have identified a huge potential here in Romania from local suppliers for all sorts of elements, whether it's superstructures or potentially for generators and for the cooling system, stuff like that. As said, another element is to look for suppliers who can do this for programs elsewhere. And the other big element of localization, which we should not forget, is the life cycle of the products. Probably these trucks will be in service for 20, 25 years or more. And it's important to have a basis of local partners who can help with the maintenance, who can help with the training. We have to follow the split of the fleets. There will be the more labor-intensive integration or final assembly for the military trucks. We are eyeing Moren to do this. For the militarized trucks, the works will be probably less complex, but a bit larger in number. And for this, we will work together with MHS. You know about the Agilis program and about the investment that is being made in Moren. We think it's taxpayers' money wisely spent to use the investment in Moren also for other programs. A lot of the requirement for machinery and tooling is quite similar. It's obviously less complex for trucks than it is for armored fighting vehicles, but we can make very good use of the infrastructure for both programs. The programs we are talking about in addition to the ongoing truck tender are programs such as the Patriot air defense system and the Lockheed Martin high mobility artillery system. For both programs, we are in permanent talks with the US companies to make sure that they will use the same trucks that will finally be used by the armed forces. It would be part of the localization that we do for the major programs in Moren.